My friends, when you are launching your products on Amazon, those first 10 to 20 reviews are extremely important. Big sellers with established brands can just go ask their fans and drive those initial high-quality reviews very easily. And that's what you eventually want to get to as well. But newbies have a lot of trouble getting those initial 10 to 20 reviews and making sure that they're not negative reviews, making sure that they're glowingly positive. So in this video, I'm going to show you a couple different ways that you can drive those initial high quality reviews without spending a fortune giving away free product. If you haven't watched my previous video about why reviews matter and what you actually need to care about when it comes to your product reviews, make sure you watch that video first. I'll put it up in the corner or something. But the overall goal with driving initial reviews during a product launch isn't the number of reviews, it's the quality of reviews and making sure that you have a really good visible star rating. Your visible star rating is going to appear next to your product across the entire Amazon platform, and it's gonna have a huge effect on your click-through rate. Once we actually get people to click on our listing, then the quality of reviews really matters. But before customers see the product reviews, they're gonna see the entire listing itself, the images, the title, the bullet points. People only scroll down all the way to the reviews if they're really on the fence whether or not they wanna buy. So make sure your product listing itself is in great shape and ready to convert before you focus on driving tons of traffic to the listing. The number of product reviews you have is not going to make or break you, but having a bad listing that doesn't convert, or even worse, a bad product that people don't like, that is going to break you. When people first get started on Amazon, they think that they have to drive a ton of reviews at a product immediately, and that's how they're going to get ranking. But Amazon understands the natural buying process. It understands that people are gonna search for a product, they're gonna click it, they're gonna buy it, they're gonna review it, and there's a bunch of time in between all of these steps. And if Amazon sees all of these reviews coming in before people have gone through that natural buying process, it's gonna know that they're not natural reviews and they're probably not gonna stick. So get the listing ready first and really focus more on conversion optimization, and don't worry about driving a huge number of reviews. You can convince people to buy your product with just 10 to 20 reviews much easier than you think. So once your listing is ready, we have got to launch the product, we got to launch the listing, and there's a lot that goes into that. But in this video, we're just going to talk about how to drive the initial product reviews within that launch process. So right after launching any new product on Amazon, your listing is in what's called the honeymoon period. And this is basically a term to describe when Amazon does not have enough data to predict what other people are going to do when they see your product in your listing. So what Amazon does is it feeds your listing a little extra data in the form of potential customers until it can predict what other people are going to do. So we've got to work hard during this honeymoon period to drive the initial reviews that we want and ultimately show the Amazon algorithm that our product is going to convert. So the goal, again, is not to flood your product with a ton of reviews on day one. We just need to trickle in some really high quality reviews throughout that honeymoon period that are hopefully going to take those people that are on the fence and turn them into buyers. But for today, we are just talking about strategies to drive those initial high quality reviews. So let's jump into it. I'll show you some of the strategies that are working right now that are completely within Amazon's terms of service and completely safe. And then towards the end of the video, I'll also show you a couple methods that are working for some sellers, but are a little bit more in the gray area and you have to be careful with. The first and the easiest method to drive those initial reviews is the Amazon Early Review program. With Amazon's early reviewer program, they will go out themselves and pay the first batch of your customers to leave those initial product reviews for you. So these are completely within Amazon's terms of service. You're literally paying Amazon for them. So there's no chance of your account being suspended for this or the reviews being wiped or anything like that. As of today, Amazon's early reviewer program costs $50, and it usually takes about 1 to 2 weeks for those reviews to actually roll in. For most sellers, the early reviewer program is a good deal, especially new sellers who haven't built up their own audience to launch their products to yet. The only downside is there is no guarantee that these are going to be good reviews. There are people who sign up for the service and get bad reviews out of it. So you've got to make sure that your products are good quality, but hopefully if you've made it this far, you're pretty confident that you're selling a high quality product. The second way to drive those initial reviews, and this is something you should be doing all the time, is using the Amazon Request a Review button. Amazon recently rolled out a button inside of Seller Central that sends out a standardized review request directly from Amazon to the customer. And right now, there is no downside to requesting a review on every single order that's placed. This button becomes available inside of the order detail page under manage orders 4 to 5 days after delivery of the product. And obviously you'd only want to click this for customers who had a good experience and you're confident are going to leave a good review. This button has been more effective so far than even the paid tools that people have set up in the past to automate this process. So you definitely want to take advantage of it, and you can even automate it using a virtual assistant or tools like Jungle Scout and many others. The third way to drive initial reviews is through just having a solid purchasing experience. Your product inserts, the packaging, the emails that you send to customers after they purchase, all of these things are going to have a drastic effect on your review rate, which the average review rate on Amazon hovers just around 1% usually. So just 1 out of every 100 purchases are actually driving a review for most sellers. But you can easily 2x, 3x, or even 10x this number through having a really effective purchasing experience, good product inserts, good packaging, and good post-purchase follow-up. Product inserts are typically going to be placed directly inside of the product packaging, but whatever message you're using the insert to communicate, you can usually get that same point across with stickers or even printing it directly on the package itself. When it comes to Amazon's terms of service, you have a lot of flexibility when it comes to your product's packaging and what is inside of it. We never want to be directly asking for a 5-star review, but we can definitely use these product inserts or what we're putting on and inside of the package to enhance the purchasing experience and just make people more likely to want to leave a review. I'm going to leave actual product insert campaigns for a separate video, but for now, just know that the purchasing experience that you create from people actually opening the product and experiencing that is going to have a drastic impact on your review rate and ultimately how many reviews you get in the long run. You've also got email follow-up systems like JumpSend or Seller Labs that will send additional post-purchase emails to customers through the Amazon system. People used to use these tools to actually request reviews, but since the Request a Review button has come out, the way that we use these tools has changed a little bit. You definitely don't want to send review requests with both methods, but you can send other follow-up emails that enhance the buyer experience and make them more likely to leave that review. Now, when it comes to product inserts and especially email follow-up, you have really got to dig into the latest Amazon communication guidelines. This is going to show you how to stay within Amazon's terms of service and make sure that not only are these reviews going to stick and actually show up on your product listing, but that your Amazon account is going to stay safe and not be suspended. So for instance, we do not want to be directly asking for 5-star reviews, and we definitely don't want to be incentivizing it or offering people money for it. But you can use these tools to help deliver a great buying experience that makes them more likely to leave a review. Maybe you just say, hey, thanks a lot for the purchase. Your support means so much to us. You are not helping some big faceless corporation. You're helping our daughter, Patricia, go through college. Thanks so much. And Patricia, this means so much to us. Tugging at the emotional heartstrings of your customers and giving them a purchasing experience that they're going to remember, that's how you're going to keep the reviews flowing in for long periods of time. Showing customers how much they mean to you and giving them a purchasing experience that they're going to remember, that's how you keep the reviews flowing in, whether you're asking for them or not. The fourth method to drive initial reviews is so much better than anything else on this list, and that's promoting it to your own audience and your own fan base. Once you're up and running and you have some existing customers, you're probably going to want to start to lean on your fan base to drive those initial sales and reviews rather than just leaving it to the Amazon Early Reviewer Program or whatever else on this list. and then just promote that new product launch to your existing customer base, however you have access to them. As we're selling product and as we're growing, we want to always be building some type of customer list, whether it's an email list, a Facebook group, the ability to run Facebook ads to our existing customers. So as you grow and this method becomes available to you, you could start to pull away from all of these other less controlled methods and just drive those initial sales and reviews from raving fans that are going to give you the high quality reviews that you're looking for. A company that does this really well is Old School Labs. You can check out their Facebook page and see how they do this. Anytime they have a new product to launch or they just want to drive some new reviews, maybe drive up their visible star rating, they just make a post on Facebook or send out an email to their existing customers and the sales and the reviews just flood in. Now, when it comes to Amazon's terms of service, you still have to be careful to not directly ask for 5-star reviews. And in general, just make sure you're not violating the communication guidelines. But you can certainly promote your new product launches to your existing customers and your biggest fans. And there's ways you can make it clear to them how much those initial reviews are going to help. All right, so now we're going to get into these strategies that are a little bit more in the gray area. And you've got to be really careful with these strategies because they are either skirting the lines of Amazon's terms of service, or they're just an outright violation and they'll get you suspended. Review manipulation is being enforced more and more by Amazon, and the punishment ranges from reviews being wiped off of your product listings to your Amazon account itself being shut down. So remember, our goal here is not to drive some huge amount of reviews. We just need a few really high quality reviews dressed up in a really nice visible star rating. The fifth method I have for you for driving initial reviews is to ask friends and family. And you have to be really careful with this one because it is very much in a gray area. How much of a gray area? Well, if you read Amazon's rules on promotional content, you'll see that friends and family are allowed to leave product reviews. They just need to clearly state that conflict of interest within the review itself. However, if we go look at the Amazon customer review guidelines, this is then contradicted, saying that anyone with a close relationship to the seller will have the review removed from the listing. So here's my thinking. When you're first getting started, it would probably make sense for you to be posting on your own personal social media profiles and share with your friends and family all of the progress that you're making in your new business. And it would make sense that those friends and family would see those posts on social media and want to do whatever they can to help support you. And maybe the review says, hey, I've been best friends with this guy for 10 years. He has put his heart and soul into this product. Let me show you how awesome it is. Look at this feature. Look at that feature. Now, these reviews will not always stick. And this is not a scalable method. It's not like we can depend on these same friends and family to launch every single product in the future. But when you're first starting out and you haven't built that fan base to launch to, friends and family can be a really vital resource. And I haven't seen anyone get their account shut down completely just for having a couple friends leave some reviews. Now, again, this is absolutely a gray area. Your account can be suspended and the reviews are often wiped away. But this is a method that almost everyone uses when they're just getting started, and I want you to know about it. Another method that is working for a lot of sellers, but is absolutely within the gray area of Amazon's terms of service, is giveaways and cash rebates. Now, you've got to be careful here, but as of 2020, you are still allowed to do cash rebates and promotional giveaways of your products. However, the new communication guidelines, which you absolutely need to go through, say that you cannot ask for a product review when you're doing any type of promotional rebate or giveaway. So services like Rebate Key, where customers can get cash back for purchasing certain products on Amazon, these are still valid and within Amazon's terms of service as of right now. However, these services are super expensive and the reviews you get from them are often wiped off of your listing completely. So you can do these cashback rebates and giveaways through a platform like Rebate Key or JumpSend, or you can just do it yourself with your own audiences or other people's Facebook groups, subreddits, things like that. All you really need to do a cashback rebate is for someone to submit their order number to you so you can reference that order number and just verify that they actually made the purchase. Once you have the order number, log into Amazon, cross-reference the order number, and issue the rebate once you verify verified that the purchase is real. You could also do this distributing one-time use coupon codes, but honestly, it's probably easier to just rebate people through the order number rather than distribute all of these different coupon codes. The next one I've got for you is something you should probably just stay away from entirely, and that is review exchange groups. These are basically Facebook groups or Discord channels or something like that, where you have tons of different Amazon sellers that are just purchasing each other's products and reviewing each other's products for one another. These were really popular a few years ago, but the truth is now Amazon can really easily identify these little clusters of users who are going around sharing reviews with each other, and it will routinely go around and wipe off all of these reviews. But this is definitely an area of review manipulation that can get your entire Amazon account suspended. So you really shouldn't use review exchange groups. And the truth of the matter is, you really don't need to use any of these tricky black hat methods to drive the initial reviews that you need. All we're really looking for is 10 to 20 ultra high quality product reviews, and we just want those within the first month or two. It doesn't have to be an overnight thing. Remember, it is not about how many reviews you have or even your product rating. It's about your visible star rating, and for those reviews that you do have, how effective are they at actually closing the customers? Customers are gonna see your visible star rating, click onto your listing, and hopefully your listing, the images, the bullet points, hopefully that's all strong enough to sell them right there and then. But if they're still on the fence, they're gonna start scrolling down and they're gonna see these ultra high quality product reviews that are gonna give them the extra confidence they need to scroll right back up and click add to cart. So focus on getting those types of reviews and just a few of them, not 100. Hopefully this video helps you guys drive those initial reviews. And if you're ever looking for a full rundown on how to launch this business from scratch, check out the free e-commerce video course that we have on startuppros.com. I will leave a link below. And guys, we've got tons of videos on YouTube about this stuff. We are answering questions all the time. So like, subscribe, comment with your questions below, and I will talk to you guys down there and in the next video. Thanks for watching, guys.